There's this thing that's called mirror neurons that's super important for us to understand. So as humans, we are hardwired to connect with one another, right? And so, which is why if we're in a classroom where we have a teacher who is creating kind of empathy, then it's going to be easier for those students to reflect that empathy back. But something else happens with these mirror neurons, right? So if I have a teacher and I have students that walk into the classroom and all of a sudden they're given a math quiz and one or more students start flipping their lid, it is a natural reaction for the other person to flip their lid as well because of these mirror neurons. And as teachers, as adults, knowing that our brain is fully developed, right? So brains become fully developed mid to late 20s. It's important to recognize when we begin to flip our lids in order that we can remain calm so that we can have the other person to be calm.
So as an educator, as a bystander who's around a child who's getting dysregulated, the best thing you can actually try to do is to stay calm. And eventually their body will start to mirror that and they'll start to feel safe because you're creating an environment that's calm. You're not adding to the dysregulation by adding other voices or loud voices or volume or, you know, getting mad or running around, but you're staying in a space and you're staying calm.
We've all seen those classrooms where it's love, care, support. There's a system in place. Everyone has a certain level of expectations that don't necessarily have to be articulated. You take a student who's had a lot of challenges and you put them into that space and they end up, right, taking on the behaviors and the energy and the love and the care and the feeling of that space. And so it's how do you scale that up as a school, right? Because you can scale that up. It just takes a lot of time, effort, energy, and resources to get there.